Hello ladies and gentlemen, this is Best in Slot here with a new mod spotlight for Skyrim. Today we're going to be looking at what is frankly probably the best mod I've ever seen. The coding, the effort that's gone into this mod is extreme. I'm just going to go make it a bit brighter. This is Ultimate Tower Defense by Titty Kitty. I will leave a link to the mod as always in the description. If you like it, do go check it out and you know, let the mod maker how much you appreciate their hard work, because clearly a lot of time has gone into this. Basically, this is a tower defense game. A lot of you will be familiar with tower defense games, whether they're flash games, whether they are, you know, walk with free mods, stuff like that. There are tower defense games all over the place. It's quite a booming genre, and someone somehow has managed to incorporate it into Skyrim. Now, I must stress, at this point in time, this is a beta game. You know, there are still bugs to be worked out. It's not going to be perfect. But, yeah. Basically, what we've done is we've gone to the north of Dawnstar, and when you load the mod, you'll have something called Leo's Boat. Like, a map marker will appear on your map. You can just fast travel there. If you'd rather not do that, you can wander around for a bit, and a courier will appear. He'll give you a note and tell you about the boat. Now, when you first get to the island, all your gear will be changed. Your follower will come with you, but they'll be changed as well. And you'll get this little menu there. So there's Lydia in her iron armour. And as you can see, my character has been relegated to iron armour as well. I'll, hopefully I can show you guys. Yeah, so we go... Here it is. That's Dawnstar. That's Leo's boat. Dawnstar, Leo's boat. Dawnstar, Leo's boat. So if you want to get here, you come to Leo's boat, you click on the boat, and that'll get you over onto this island. Now, at the start, all you have to do is wander around and kill these first Draugr. I have to stress, also, things like the difficulty of this tower defense, a lot of you will find this a little bit easy the first time you do it. But, now, if this isn't really the tower defense, this is just a kind of an opening little gambit. Yeah, a lot of you will find it easy the first time, but once you've completed it once, you unlock the ability to edit the difficulty and various things like that. You can edit a lot more options once you've done it once. So we're going to choose medium difficulty. We are going to fight against... I fought against Draugr last time I did this. We're going to fight against bandits. And now you'll get to this kind of screen once you've done that the first time. And this is your little tower you've got to defend. Doesn't look like much now. There's an apothecary woman you can buy potions from her with gold. Basically, like all tower defences, there are four resources. Well, not always four, but you get my point. There are resources you've got to use. You've got gold, which you get for killing enemies. You've got iron, wheat and wood, which we'll use to upgrade and buy potions and stuff like that. Lydia's gone a little crazy. So I'll show you the upgrade menu. What you do is you get this spell, this fire spell in your right hand at the end of each round, and that lets you start the next round. It lets you buy barricades, lets you buy soldiers that wander around and help you out, like a tower defense game. We can also upgrade our own armor, we can buy resource gatherers, we can upgrade the tower, all this stuff. First round's fairly easy, so I would recommend getting a miner and a lumberjack. Actually, I'm going to get two of each. Wood and ingots, which is what lumberjacks and miners get you, are by far the most important resources in my experience. Might change at harder difficulty levels, but at this point, that's what I'd recommend going for. We're also going to buy a soldier. We are going to buy... We've got enough gold for a couple of fighters. So you click fighter and... This will change a little bit, and as you can see, we've got this red marker. It's quite hard to see, but we just right click, and there's our fighter. We can buy another one, stick him down. Don't want to buy another one, and there we go. We have two fighters which will now assist with our tower defense. The tower itself doesn't really die. The point is to keep yourself alive, which, like I said, when you first play it for the first time, isn't going to be that difficult. But if you want to up the difficulty, all you do is complete it once, get the basics down, and then you'll be able to go off and then you'll be able to go off and raise the difficulty and give yourself a bit more of a challenge. So we're just going to do round one, and let's go ahead and get a sword. Okay, we favorited that. Beautiful. The round will start and enemies will start appearing.
What
it's
that?
So cool. Just look at all your resources. So here, mining these giant rocks for the iron. The farm, lumberjacks over there. It's so cool. The amount of work that's gone into this mod. It is. Yeah, the fights are kind of amazing. Let's just watch them beat this bandit up. Like I said, this will become far more difficult on higher difficulties, obviously. Plus, the difficulty of the enemies is actually dependent on the difficulty of your game as well. So your own game settings. For the purposes of this video, I've set mine back to, oh god, I'm killing a fighter, aren't I? Sorry, fighter. Sorry. Oh, bad times. You a bandit? You're a bandit. Are you a bandit? You're a fighter. You're a fighter. You were a bandit. Anyways, that's Lydia. Right, you're definitely a bandit. Okay, so yeah, you can up the difficulty, and it does depend on yours. Like I said, I've changed my difficulty to Adept, I think, for this one, just the second difficulty level, whichever that is. Just for the purposes. I don't really want to spend ages in the fights, I'm just trying to show you how this plays out, really. As you see in the top left, you also have a count that shows how many enemies you have left to kill. That should be round over. Any second now my weapon will go and be... Oh no! Little thing, you can still use Dragon Rend. At the end of each round, there's like a small chance of a dragon spawning, and if you kill the dragon, which in this case is an elder dragon, last time I had a normal. This is going to be fun. No, it's not that bad. Again, low difficulty. If you kill the dragon, that rewards you with an extra 200 gold on top of what you would already have. So each round there's a small chance of a dragon spawning. I've done 4 rounds so far and there has been a dragon twice, so the chance clearly isn't that low. But once the round's over, you can go buy stuff again. So I'm going to upgrade the castle, I think. Actually, we're going to upgrade armour because that helps a lot. So we're going to upgrade to... We're going to get some dwarven armour. And this upgrades your follower as well. So there's Naked Lydia. And there's not Naked Lydia. Oopsie daisy. And we're going to upgrade the castle. Now, upgrading the castle doesn't really do much, but it looks cool. It gives you some place to hide. It's all... It just looks good, which is really the key point. Upgrade. And it'll actually pop up and show you what the upgrade is going to look like, which is very, very cool, I think. It'll come up saying, do you want to purchase the upgrade? Yes. And now we look up there, and there's another bit to the tower. So, we're going to get the next one. Apologies, had to sneeze. I had to very quickly mute my mic. We're going to start the next round. You can also buy barricades, which are like little, basically sticks in the ground that when the enemy walks over them, they take damage. And you can upgrade your fighter's armor as well. There's so many options. It is really, really quite cool. Right, Lydia.
What's the hurry?
So we're going to do another round. Are you attacking my... Yeah, they will attack your resource gatherers. So you kind of have to try and protect your miners and stuff. Like any tower defense game, really. Okay, I think it's okay. I think he's doing okay. So each round more enemies will spawn as well. As you see this round there's 17 enemies remaining. I think there's 20 in the round total, whereas last time there was only 10. And that is pretty much it from this point on. You keep going through the rounds and you keep killing enemies and you keep upgrading stuff. I'll play to the end of this round and do another round of upgrades, just to lovely. Just to show you guys the general gist of it. But this is Ultimate Tower Defense by Titty Kitty. yeah. I'm not quite sure what a Titty Kitty is. I'm not quite sure I want to know. Either way, I will link the mod in the description. Please do go check it out because the amount of work in this is amazing. And they are quite dedicated to making sure it's updated, making sure all the bugs are fixed because there are issues. Last time I played this, at the end of the next round, there's one enemy remaining who just wasn't anywhere to be found. But with a mod this extravagant and over the top and... Over the top sounds bad. With a mod this extravagant and coding heavy and such things, it's only expected there's going to be a few problems. But I'm sure they'll all be ironed out and it's better to get in on the ground floor, really. So I hope you guys do check it out, because if any mod deserves your support, it is pretty much this one.
There's someone there.
Now, you can place your archers and stuff up there, you know, if you think you're going to defend your tower and they're going to sort of stand there and shoot arrows, which is quite a cool classic tower defense move. You know, you put your archers on the high ground, obviously. But they will move, they will come down, they will run around trying to attack the enemies. Unfortunately. Maybe in the future they'll have an option to keep the archers there, or maybe they're meant to. But who knows? So many things they could all incorporate into this. So many different things. Now, unfortunately, it looks like it has bugged a little bit again. Oh no, there she is. See, sometimes this will happen. It's not necessarily a bug. Basically, move, bandit. Come here, little bandit. Basically, if you have one enemy left and the music stopped, it means they've decided not to run and attack your castle. Maybe they're standing around the edge somewhere, waiting. So you just need to go and search them out. And we have a dragon again. So they're really not that rare. What have we got this time? Is that a frost dragon? Yeah. Anyways, I highly recommend playing through at least... Oh god, I'm gonna die. I highly recommend playing through the first 5 levels or so, and then you, I'll show you this in a second. Okay. If we go into this, if we go into all, you get something called UCD configuration. This lets you change the enemy type, the difficulty, whether you want dragons to spawn or not. Change the weather, if you want it to be, Blood Moon, why not? And as you can see there, additional enemy types, game modifiers and round settings will be unlocked after completion of the initial 5 waves. So as you do more, more will unlock. It makes sense. It gives people these first 5 levels as kind of a taster, so they know what's going on. And we are going to upgrade our tower again. I think that's what I want to do. I don't seem to be getting much wood. Maybe I've lost my... Yeah, as you can see, I've lost the miner and both of my lumberjacks. So let's... I don't know if I'm going to be able to upgrade the tower. Oh, I can. Let's have a look, see what this does. As you see, there's another big back tower. The further back tower that wasn't there earlier. And our castle is slowly becoming an actual castle. And Blood Moon is terrifying as it's always been. Let's see what else we can buy just to show you guys some more stuff. Maybe we can upgrade the armor of our soldiers. Yeah, let's get some dwarven armor. And as you can see, they both vanish, and any second now, we have Dwarven Armor Fighters.
Yeah.
That's all I'm going to show you for this for now. Such a well-made mod. I can't stress how good this mod is. It's like an entirely new game. You know, you could package this and sell it. It's so cool. And it's got so much scope for, you know, more upgrades, more, like, your tower taking damage, sieging, bombardment, all this kind of stuff you can add. I should mention you can actually buy your original equipment back for 800 gold and 5 ingots. But this makes every enemy twice as difficult. Which makes sense, you know, if you've got overpowered gear, you'd walk through this. But either way, that is Ultimate Tower Mod by Titty Kitty over on at least Steam, possibly Skyrim Nexus. If it is on Skyrim Nexus, the link will be in the description of this mod, as it always is. Please do go like and endorse and all that kind of stuff, because it's just fantastic. I can't stress how cool this is. It is an entirely new game. Ah, so happy. Okay, thank you for joining me, guys. This has been Best in Slot. We have been playing Ultimate Tower Defense... Ultimate Tower Mod? Ultimate Defense Mod? God, I can't even remember now. Ultimate Tower Defense, that's the one. Ultimate Tower Defense Mod. Please do like, comment, subscribe the video. It really does help massively. It means, you know, I can keep doing things like this. And much love, guys, for all the support and stuff, and for watching, as always. See you next video. Cheers. Bye.